Two-time Olympian turned barrister Zali Steggall will take on Tony Abbott in his Sydney seat of Warringah at the next election.
If you get rid of Tony Abbott, you change the Liberal Party. If you change the Liberal Party, you change the country.
We wouldn't be in Warringah if it wasn't for Get Up.
We are unashamedly campaigning to unseat Tony Abbott.
I don't think I've ever seen a race for any seat that is such high stakes, but is also so bizarre.
I have no doubt it's going to get dirty.
I don't want anyone to hurt her, physically hurt her.
It's only Tony and I, so it's become a bit personal.
The people of Warringah are not just choosing a local member, they're choosing a government.
I've always thought that the most appropriate person to take him down would be a woman.
Welcome, I'm Zali Steggall, and today I announce that I'll be an independent candidate in the next federal election in Warringah.
I was born in Manly and my first few years were in Manly. Both my parents loved skiing and so they decided that they wanted to go and live in the French Alps for a couple of years. They put us into school and so we learnt French and grew up in the mountains. I was a very competitive person as a child. And I do remember just clearly thinking, well, someone's got to make it to the top and there are no rules, so why not me?
She's definitely got an incredible sporting ability, but she's got an incredible mind. And it's that mind that really allows her to shut out the noise, break it down, and do what is required.
I met Tim at a Sea Eagles Melbourne Cup lunch. He had three young girls from his first marriage and I had two young boys from my first marriage. And we really very quickly were in sync. We just formed a great partnership where we had the same values and priorities. It really was for us about forming a family and being there for our kids.
Zali and I have been together for, you know, say, 12 and a half years. We've been married for over 10 years. I am hopelessly in love, still, which I'm sure drives her nuts. But it's fantastic.
Four-time Olympian turned barrister Zali Steggall is set to announce that she will take on Tony Abbott in his Sydney seat of Warringah at the next election.
The seat on Sydney's northern beaches has always been in Liberal hands. It's been Tony Abbott's since 1994 and he retains a primary vote of 51%.
The task of any independent taking on Tony Abbott, a former Prime Minister, is a gargantuan one. He's been the local member for 25 years. Everybody knows him and he has a huge profile whether you like him or not.
Former Prime Minister Tony Abbott is under a full frontal assault from Labor, Get Up, the unions, the independent candidate that they're all backing and all sorts of other people who'd love to see the back of him.
This is a bloke who spends his summers fighting bushfires. This is a man who spends his summers at the beach. Not sunning, but being part of the life-saving brigade. Good luck taking him on.
Marvellous place to live in down here at Manly, particularly on the beach side here. It's certainly got a certain culture and lifestyle which most people envy and I enjoy it.
You can travel, you come home and you realise how beautiful it is. We've got beautiful beaches, we've got a fantastic harbour. It's a wonderful life. We live a wonderful life.
Warringah is one of the most affluent electorates in Australia. It's beautiful, it has a lot of harbour frontage and beaches, and it skews old, so it has a lot of retirees in it, and it is a very, very liberal seat.
This is a conservative area, and I've been brought up in a conservative household, and I'd have to say I'm a very conservative voter. I've got my background as conservative, I'm a businessman.
So I'll probably be voting Liberal and Tony Abbott. I think he's a great guy, and I think he's done a lot for that community.
As for my age group, I think most people are going to vote Liberal. But things will be clear if Tony went.
Tony Abbott has a huge personal following and a lot of really strong Liberal loyalty, particularly from rusted on Liberal voters. But things are changing.
I think he doesn't represent Warringah. I mean, we voted for marriage equality. 75% of us voted for marriage equality. And yet he chose to proselytise the no case and then didn't even vote.
It starts with one person and then you have a conversation with someone else and then they have a conversation with someone else and all of a sudden I'm sending messages out to 30,000 people at a time. My name's Mark Kelly and I'm the founder of Vote Tony Out. I started the campaign because of pure frustration. Tony Abbott and how he was acting in Parliament. We've sold about 5,000 of those, very popular. Another popular item has been the Vote Tony Out budgie smugglers. They've been really good. So in Warringah, the big thing that has changed since the 2013, 2016 and now election is the core values of the electorate are actually changing, but Tony's core values haven't.
We then had the events of last year with the toppling of a Prime Minister and I think a really big disruption of a government that was working well.
They rang and said, hey, what are you guys doing for a candidate? So I put her in touch with a lot of people in the coalition of groups. And they sort of fast-tracked her. It was quite, everyone was really, really impressed with not only her ability, but who she was as a person.
I just really felt that we needed an alternative choice.
I'm into visualisations and making things happen, you know. And so I've done a visualisation which says that we win the election and we win on the primary vote. And finding a candidate was just part of that. So Zali is, you know, it's all just manifesting itself. It's pretty interesting.
Welcome, I'm Zali Steggall and today I announce that I'll be an independent candidate in the next federal election in Warringah.
Now you say that Tony Abbott is out of touch with voters, but why would a former Olympic skier be any more in tune with the needs of voters than Tony Abbott?
Well, I think I've done a little bit more than just be an Olympic skier. I'm a mum, I have teenagers, I'm very aware of the pressures we are under. I've been operating my own business for 10 years as a barrister.
So sure, she's a barrister. Sure, she comes from a family that apparently is traditionally liberal, but she's not a liberal.
A lot of people say that Zali Steggall is not a true liberal in the small liberal sense, particularly on economic issues like Labor's economic reform proposals.
I don't support the proposed changes to superannuation, negative gearing, and franking credits.
I think the Advance Australia and the Tony Abbott campaign line that Zali Steggall is the get-up candidate is quite an effective line against her because she's someone who is a political clean skin that nobody really knows anything about and she doesn't have the sort of backing in the brand management that Tony Abbott does.
I'm an independent. I'm asking the people of Warringah to give me their vote. Vote one for Zali above the line.
You, of course, have been accused of being aligned with get-up, are you?
No, not at all.
In no shape or form?
No shape or form.
No donations, no favours?
No donations, no favours.
Hey, nice to meet you. I've got an onion for you. Oh, I can't wait.
Let's all think back to the time that Tony single-handedly destroyed any chance of progress on climate policy in this country.
We are unashamedly campaigning to unseat Tony Abbott because of how destructive his role has been in holding back action on climate change. So Get Up campaigns for climate action, not candidates. We're fiercely independent. The Australian Electoral Commission actually did a very thorough investigation of Get Up and found that we are an independent and issues-based organisation.
Is this it?
Yeah, I reckon.
So there will have been 1,000 volunteers involved in the Warringah campaign by election day, and they've been talking to thousands and thousands of their fellow voters.
We've always said from the start, we wouldn't be in Warringah if it wasn't for Get Up. It would be the largest focus, you know, there's no doubt about that. My name is Jared Benedett. I'm the National Director of an organisation called Advance Australia. Advance Australia is a movement of mainstream Australians who want to protect, advance and defend mainstream values and freedoms. What do I think of Tony Abbott? While being a controversial character at times, I think when you look at his community service record, it stands out amongst politicians who these days are a little plain and vanilla. So we've got volunteers who are letterboxing, we've put material out ourselves, we've got a mobile truck running around the electorate as well. We're only 6 months old, GetUp's 14 years old, and we want to be around in the political landscape, not just this election, but the one after that and the one after that.
I think that with friends like Advance Australia, with their notorious climate denier backer Maurice Newman, Tony Abbott doesn't need enemies.
So our support for Tony Abbott is through our opposition to Zali Steggall. And vice versa, Get Up support for Zali Steggall is through their opposition to Tony Abbott.
Enjoy your retirement, Tony.
Zali Steggall's supporters are not sort of dreadlocked hippies by any stretch. They're rich, they're affluent, they're educated, they're bankers' wives. And Zali herself had her campaign launch at the Novotel in Manly, which is a pretty ritzy venue.
It's very electric in there. People are just so excited.
I think Tony's shitting himself.
His conviction makes him something
of a mad king. I hope we're in the final act of King Lear when it comes to Tony.
Now this is our time. We can all feel it. Our community is standing up. We are making our voices heard. So what are we waiting for? Thank you.
Like people were, you know, nodding their head and clapping and cheering and all that sort of stuff, but you looked unreal.
Tonight is the start. Even though they mightn't have called an election to us, we're starting.
I visited the Governor-General here in Canberra and he accepted my advice for an election to be held on the 18th of May.
The people of Warringah are not just choosing a local member, they're choosing a government.
Obviously very proudly kind of waving these signs.
Well, I just like the country to stay liberal as it is. Thank you very much.
So stories in the newspapers. Abbott's diabolical polling in Warringah. What feedback have we had on the stories?
It's put everyone in a pretty positive mood, I think, knowing that we're on our way to hopefully victory.
Well, since the election's been called, it's been obviously very exciting. It's been nice to have an actual date to work towards. We've reached 1,100 volunteers now, I think.
Any stories we need to be worried about?
There is still a little bit of concern about the get up thing, but we've got our absolute line that we're completely independent, because that's exactly what we are.
Well, I had read that Advance Australia were trying to be GetUp's answer to the right wing. Rather than campaigning on issues, they seem to be just dragging up dirt and telling lies.
Yeah, well, our material in Warringah has been truthful. Zali Steggall went on the record and said that she'd never voted Liberal at a federal election for the last 20 years. We thought voters needed to know those facts.
They've got a truck driving around Warringah with where they've photoshopped Zali's dress from blue to red and got her in a picture with Bill Shorten.
No, I'm pretty sure that it's an accurate photo. If she doesn't have a red dress, then we may have made it red. I'm not sure.
Chicken Man is a costumed person of unknown provenance that keeps showing up at Zali Steggall's public appearances. But Chicken Man has not been claimed by any party, and in fact the Liberal Party says it's definitely nothing to do with them.
Oh look, they're pretty chicken really, is the best way to describe it.
Look, they're clearly there from Tony's team or Liberals or Advance Australia, but it's pretty desperate.
Let's just clarify this. Your Wikipedia page has been altered and you've been described as a men's magazine model who appeared nude for a pear industry campaign and also appeared wearing lingerie in a men's magazine as a former sportswoman. What can you do about it?
Oh, look, Wikipedia, at least you can get them to change it and lock down the page, so that's fine. But it's more what it means and what kind of leadership are you inspiring if your followers think that that's a way to win an election?
To be really honest with you, I don't want anyone to hurt her, physically hurt her, because I look at some of the trolls and some of the things you read and you're just going, wow, I hope they don't own a gun.
There's no doubt it will get dirty, but just because that's what they choose to do doesn't mean that's what we will choose to do.
So Nick sent me that campaign today that he saw out in the streets of Mossman, which I thought was really quite interesting.
All the information we have from the electorate is that people find that really tacky, and it's just that dirty politics that they're really not interested in.
How about some action on climate change?
The so-called settled science is not quite as settled as people say.
The sooner you're out, the better.
This morning, we're very lucky to have some of the main candidates standing in Warringah. Tony Abbott, of course, and, of course, Zali Steggall. Should we be in Paris or not?
I'm not calling for us to pull out now.
You were?
Yeah.
But now you're not.
Circumstances have changed.
And what's the change?
We've got a new Prime Minister and a new Energy Minister.
So when Malcolm Turnbull was Prime Minister, we should get out of Paris.
We had an emissions obsession that needed to be broken, and it's now changed.
It is the cheapest form of production of power is renewables, Mr. Abbott.
Not
and
24/7.
Anyone, it is.
When the there wind is blows, a, it's cheap.
That is the most ludicrous argument that gets touted all the time, the intermittency.
Well, now, let's abolish all the subsidies.
Would you mind?
I know that's your time, but the reality is the electorate actually want to hear, and these people want to hear. Right.
I look forward to another debate. I have been told that he doesn't generally do too many debates, and I don't know if the experience he had from our first one would make him want to come back for more.
Just another one that way, smiling.
Okay.
There we go. One, two, three, and...
good luck.
Thank you. Thank you.
I mean, you've got to read the papers. Every day there's a different twist and turn.
I haven't seen any negative stuff about Zali around Manly at all. I've seen negative stuff about Tony.
So Tony Abbott has been the subject of some really quite nasty attacks in this campaign. There were pictures of his face that were stuck up all over the electorate with obscenities written across them.
It's definitely not something we would ever do, and any suggestion that it would be is something we would take extremely seriously. It's actually a ridiculous question to be asking.
He had a book with some feces that was left outside his electoral office with the word unpopular written across it. And then there was an ad that was pulled by GetUp, which depicted him as a lifesaver.
Look, I think you'll find that the science isn't settled on that.
What? Do something.
Why should we act first?
Look, GetUp ought to hang their heads in shame, frankly. GetUp and their candidate ought to hang their heads in shame, because 150,000 plus surf lifesavers of Australia should be treated with more respect than GetUp did.
Yeah, so that ad was very insensitive, and we heard the concerns of lifesavers, which is why we immediately cancelled the ad and apologised. It was clearly insensitive.
Steggall, on the other hand, has been subject of some trolling on her Facebook account, and there was an ad that was put out by the Advance Australia activist group, which had Captain GetUp gyrating and rubbing himself against a large picture of her face.
Captain GetUp is a satirical character, like a mascot that you'd see at a footy match, who is travelling around the country to marginal seats to make sure people are aware of GetUp's agenda. The idea was brainstormed by us. Can't say that anyone has full responsibility, but ultimately I'm the boss, so it lies with me. Sadly, he's had a couple of death threats across social media.
The sexualised dancing he did in front of Zali was just really off-putting. I just think it was demeaning of women, and I can't understand why they did it.
That was a mistake. We put our hand up and we've apologised. Won't happen again.
This can be a tough workout.
It is.
So if there's any frustration from work or campaigning, coming to the gym at night and getting a workout is a really great way of getting physically tired, so it switches off your brain a bit, and it's a great de-stressor. Politics is certainly ripe with sexist treatment, but it's also ripe for change, is the way I look at it. Nothing's been that easy. I studied law while having two babies. I took them to weekend school. I studied at night in between sleep patterns. I don't think Tony Abbott's ever had to worry about that issue.
How does it feel being married to Zali? Look, really exciting. I know, obviously.
He'll be gushing.
As a father of three daughters, just really proud. She is so determined for women.
Especially when I've heard some of his comments, and the more derogatory ones about women.
What the housewives of Australia need to understand as they do the ironing.
I've always thought that the most appropriate person to take him down would be a woman.
Well, good afternoon and welcome to the Sky News Manly Daily Warringah debate. This is one of the most fascinating individual seat contests in this election. But would you support in supply and confidence either side in a minority government?
My preference on supply and confidence will be the coalition. But then, when it comes to legislation, of course, climate change is my priority.
Climate change is the most important issue. You think that the Labor Party doesn't go far enough. That means, presumably, that you would prefer a Labor government to a Liberal one.
I want a bipartisan approach to our children's future.
The fear of losing is actually something that really paralyzes a lot of athletes in sport, because if you're so worried about defeat, you actually can't risk everything and succeed.
And I have to say, it has been such an amazing time since announcing on the 27th of January. I was really motivated to come and offer Warringah a choice for a new era.
Anything other than a vote for Liberal brings a Labor government closer, and that's the last thing that we should want for the people of Warringah.
All right, Tony Abbott, thank you.
I think Zali's going to do it. I think she'll make it.
She hasn't got a track record, whereas Tony has got a track record.
The incumbent Tony Abbott will probably get across the line.
It would mean a lot for Warringah if he's voted out, but it would mean more for Australia.
She has done history-making feats before, and I see this as another one.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.